G'day, welcome back, my friends. Grab a coffee. Hang on, where's the coffee? Welcome back, my friends. Round two, let's go. Oppenheimer celebration week. Getting you guys ready. Make sure you come back each day. Day two of talking about nukes, and still yet to hear from the FBI, so all is well. So before we get into it, my name's Dylan. I just put a PhD in physics on hold to create some fun things. And my AI project, AIMyInterior.com, is now out. You can use it for free. No credit card, I should say that. Take a picture of your room, you upload the picture to my site, and you can choose whatever interior design style you want. It'll do it in like 30 seconds. Massive thank you to everyone who's already tested out AMI Interior. AMI Cars is also right around the corner. Let's get into the video. Nuclear bombs destruction comparison 3D. Let's go. Little boy. So we talked to little boy about little boy in the yesterday's one quite a bit. So go check it out. Kiloton. I can't really read it. My damn books are in front. Bomb dropped on Japanese. Yes, city. Terrible. Did you guys ever hear about how like two students built an atom bomb? So in like 1964, the US military, they were trying to figure out how easy it would be for, you know, other countries to figure out how to make an atom bomb, right? If you want a full video on this, let me know, because this is a long story. So I'm just going to really quickly what happened. So they're trying to work out if you just pulled a bunch of amateurs off the street, how quickly they could build an atom bomb and if they could even figure it out. So they found these two guys with PhDs in physics, right? One of them was 28, so a year older than what I am now. This is in 1964. And so, yeah, they didn't give them any of their secrets that these guys knew. They were obviously secrets. They just had access to the physics, right? Their little notebooks. Two guys. They weren't given anything. They just had to write the plans out, so they weren't able to test anything, okay? And then when they were done, they had to sort of hand it in. 2.5 years later, right, they thought they were done. They gave the plans in. And then at a dinner a couple of weeks later, their commander, you know, came over to talk to them. And he said something like, you know, I bet you guys want to know that that thing would have went off. And he said something like, yeah, it would have made a pretty big bang. And they asked apparently how big a bang, and apparently a comparable bang to Hiroshima. So just two people with PhDs in physics were able to create the plans for an atom bomb. The plans were so good apparently that, you know, your local mechanic could have built this thing, sort of thing. 2.5 years, that's all they needed. Two guys without any prior knowledge. They didn't have access to the secrets. So it's kind of scary, no? And they were just like students, essentially. And I remember reading one of them, they didn't really have much knowledge of them at all. Like, so they had PhDs in physics, but they didn't have, you know, huge amount of knowledge on specifically nuclear physics. And like one guy apparently said, you know, his extent of knowledge on nuclear weapons were like, you know, that you just need to bring a bunch of fissile material together, and that was it. And so I guess the US government found out that, yeah, any country is going to be able to build these things if they have just decent education, and they get a little bit lucky, I guess. Don't worry too much, guys, because the major challenge, I guess, is getting all the fissile material, which is actually really quite difficult. And obviously, you know, you need two very smart people. But I reckon I could do it. Don't tell anyone. Moderate blast damage. Thermal radiation. Wow, this is quite intense. They've got everything. Light blast damage. Fat man. Not too much more powerful. Just a bit rounder around the edges. Literally, the bomb is just a little rounder. So if you know your history, you might have heard how Heisenberg kind of like failed to build the bomb for Germany. And if you know your physics, Heisenberg might sound familiar to Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. Probably, in my opinion, one of the most, if not the most important thing in all of physics. And he also derived quantum mechanics. He's matrix mechanics, which is a really important way to learn it. You don't learn it, get taught it that way at first, generally, but you'll come back to learn it that way because it is definitely necessary to go further into things like second quantization and quantum field theory. But the Farm Hall documents kind of tell a different tale. as Heisenberg actually told the interviewer how to build the bomb. He described how a sphere of uranium-235 with a diameter of, 54 centimeters, weighing about a ton, could sustain a chain reaction of 80 collisions using, very fast neutrons, and generating 1,024 neutrons. But only a quarter of a ton would be necessary, of course, he said, if the uranium was covered with the reflector. And so, the bombs could be made to explode at the right moment by bringing together two halves, right, which were too small to generate a chain reaction when separate. And, so both the reflector and the idea of bringing together two subcritical masses of uranium at the right moment are essential parts of the bomb. And Hans Bethe, one of the, the big theoreticians for the American bomb program, said after, hearing these documents that Heisenberg clearly knew a lot more than he always thought. And I'm pretty, I think this just suggests to me that he clearly knew how to build the bomb, and he basically derailed, he prevented Germany from winning the war with the nuclear bomb, which is pretty amazing. And if you were watching just before, you might have heard how, two physics PhDs learned how to do it in 2.5 years, and Heisenberg is a genius. So I suspect, he knew how to do it. So there's quite a bit to that story. Like, he claimed, he actually kind of suggested that he kind of did know how to do it as well. But a lot of historians don't believe him. Because, right before the end of the war, he pretended like he didn't know how. There's also some other evidence, he, not long after he told this conference after Hiroshima, all this information about the bomb, and all of his kind of colleagues were surprised, they'd clearly never heard it before. So that was also kind of evidence that he knew more, and he wasn't really, telling Germany how to go about building the bomb. It's a very cool video though. Pakistani bomb, fire 45 kiloton. Wow. Not sure the song fits. Wouldn't be my first choice. Thermal radiation, light blast damage. Did you guys know that Einstein actually famously apparently commented, this is just sort of like a legend, that if he had known that his theories would have been used to create the atom bomb, he said that he would have became a locksmith. Indian bomb, 60 kiloton. Yeah, I don't even know how to... Nice little mushroom cloud there. North Korean bomb, 150 kilotons, so it's quite the step up. Yeah. Yeah, wrong song choice. Topple SS-25 Russia, 800 kiloton. So they're showing way more bombs in this one. But these are all nuclear bombs, by the way, if you didn't know so far. I'm pretty sure from memory. So you might have also heard how, physicists at the time were kind of worried that they might set the atmosphere alight and just kill the whole world or something, right? And turn, Earth into a little star or something. But it was a serious concern at first, but Oppenheimer, the man himself, did some calculations. Well, he got a team together, I'm pretty sure. And they did some calculations and they pretty much worked out that this was an impossibility very early on. And then there was some misinformation spread through a newspaper report, yada yada. I think they worked out though that with maybe, bigger bombs, you could maybe do it. like, you know, the size of hydrogen bombs. But then, so, you know, down the track when we started building hydrogen bombs, a lot of nuclear physicists, though, they weren't concerned about the hydrogen bombs either. They had done the necessary calculations. So, yeah, there's a big one. B-83 USA. So the animation of the bombs themselves are pretty bad because it's not very accurate. Dongfeng 5, China, 5 megaton. Yeah, that's a bit of a step up. Ivy Mike, USA, 10.4 megaton. Radiation radius. Blast damage. Moderate blast damage. Turn it down a bit, eh? Castle Bravo. We're going to talk about this one in a separate video, so we'll save this one. Yeah, it's pretty big. Tsar Bomber. We've talked about this one a fair bit already. Only on day two. Heavy blast damage. Yes. And as I said yesterday, I believe, it was meant to be 100 megaton. They halved it. This is a better song choice. Ah, so they're showing what it was meant to be, eh? It says on the right, only theoretical. You could show lots of bombs here if we're gonna go there. I mean, there's still a bit of video, so what are they gonna show? 1 to 4. Oh, this is a good little comparison. Nice. The final one. Thanks for watching, guys. Make sure you come check out AIMyInterior.com. You can use it for free. No credit card. Make sure you subscribe. Come back tomorrow because there'll be another video celebrating, you know, the release of Oppenheimer on July 20th. So make sure you come back because I know how nukes work and I know where you live.